crossed a couple of years ago, I just fell in love with the collective that you are currently a part of, still, Urban Village. But you're one space cadet who likes to really stretch yourself in as far as your musicality is concerned. Born in Soweto, this artistic flair that you have.
To be quite honest, like, it comes from home, you know. I come from a huge family of musicians.
Yes.
And I was raised by my mother's family mostly, you know. And bomalume bayacula kuthi lunch abang badlala iginqi, you know. Esontweni sikhule sicula, you know. So it was a space for me, you know, to be also, you know, be involved in. And it's mamela ma vinyl, and you know, that I think also contributed a lot, you know.
Yes.
And not that I want to give away my age, but we used to really listen to turntables and then vinyls.
Yes, yes. No, I do as well. You know, I mean, you should see my collection. But this man is mature. You had a good run with Urban Village, and you guys are still having the most beautiful run. But where did this urge, you know, for you to somehow explore uncharted territories come through?
Yeah, as Babu Mnisine, I mean, remember, as Urban Village, we are all creatives and musicians in our own spaces,
right.
You know. It has always been a thing for me where...
Four of you, right?
Four of us, yes.
Yes.
And it has always been a thing for me to also, like, you know, want to get into a space where I could, like, really get to learn and experience things differently. I never thought I could learn how to act, sing, dance at the same time, you know. It's another space,
it's
you know.
Another
so,
space, yes.
You know, got into theater with that Ikaste Umoja, and I'd learned so much from there, you know. But also, you know, the journey did not end there, because obviously, you know, there's something that I actually wanted, which is to really play my music and to be able to tell my story,
right.
You know. And and it's the thing of trying to open up new doors and see how far you could go and how far you could stretch the art, because I pedele la kanga uti pedele khona, you know. And I think for me, the journey is still carrying on, really, and I learn as I go every single day.
I mean, Umoja, you know, we're talking now theater.
Yeah.
What was your contribution there, and how much did you learn actually?
So my contribution was voice, really. You know,
yes.
I'd met someone who had bumped in Estratini and who had me playing the guitar, you know, during a work break, and he was interested in the voice, and that's when I got that opportunity. But I didn't know what to mean among figure lap meling chime. I didn't know anything about acting.
Yeah, it's part of stage.
I thought I was just going to get there and just sing, because that's what I know how to do.
Yes.
But, you know, theater and being part of a musical, you have to learn how to act, dance, and sing at the same time. So I've learned so much, you know, through that space. And again, I'm very grateful of that, having that opportunity. You know, now mom taught, mom Tembi Nyande, you know, they really taught me so much.
Yeah, the greats, you know, coming out of Umoja. And of course, that production has gone around the world.
Absolutely.
Has it settled?
I'm not sure. As angeke wazi, because yazi kwesinye isikhathi uzocabanga ukuthi lele kanti isazilungisa ishintsha amagera ngithi kufana nemvula babumnisi makayibiza iqala liguqubale kuqala, you know, ubone ngathi li, you know, then there's lightning, then there's thunder, and then it pours.
In there. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're joining us, and we're streaming this one live on our two platforms, that is Facebook as well as YouTube, Radio 2000 _ ZA. Tell us, Lele Lingo.
Yeah. You mean like a live one?
Yes,
oh wow.
Yeah.
Oh, wow, thank you so much for that opportunity. I wasn't ready. Y'all caught me off guard. It just pours anytime.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's see, where are you? He's right here. There you are.
So this next one I'm going to play is called Zibonakalise, meaning show yourself. It's a song I'd written, you know, during, you know, the pandemic that we've been going through, not knowing whether we're coming or going and needing a solution, you know. And for me, it was a thing of, you know, just making a plea to our ancestors, to give us that opportunity and show us the way.
Indeed.
Because we do not know whether we're coming or going. Oh. So Zibonakalise. I hope you'll enjoy it.
Oh, Tubatsi Maloy.
No one on a mother, na 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 ya, no one, Sikulegile gunina. Sikulegile gunina bon kuluba. Sikulegile gunina. Awa haigo. Yei, sikulegile gunina bon kuluba. Sikulegile gunina. Matonga mahle fuma Sinyanya silele pagamani woha Matonga mahle fuma nbo Msegwane sibona galiseni E na 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 da E la le na 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 le Ella le na na la le ah. Ella le na na la le ah. Ella le na na la le. Ella le na na la ye. Matunga mahle fumani bo. Sinyanyazi lele. Pagamanbo Matonga mahle fumani bo Usegwane sibona galiseni nina Gimali na yona mayo
Ladies and gentlemen, Duba Tsimloi, Matonga Mahle.
Thank you.
Ready, 2000 our music, your memory.
online and on your mobile. This is Radio 2000 Traffic.
Good afternoon. Starting off in Gauteng, the R21 northbound in Kempton Park has a stationary vehicle near Voortrekker Road. Main Road northbound in Bryanston has a crash near Robin Road, and Klerkop Road eastbound has delays towards Zierfontein Avenue. In KZN on the N3, that's slow moving at Marion Hill Toll Plaza. The N3 westbound has a crash at Camperdown that's causing delays, and the N2 southbound has a stationary vehicle just before Spaghetti Junction. In Cape Town, the M3 Philip Hosanna Drive outbound has a crash at Hospital Bend. Kielbasson Drive in Paro has a crash near Voortrekker Road, and Main Road southbound is slow moving between Claremont and Wynberg. That's the latest on the roads. I'm Irma G.
Tune in anytime. You'll hear the hits you like. Feel good music. Radio 2000. Drive Connection on Radio 2000, a human connection by design.
Stay as you are till the day you can no longer. Even myself, I know all the days that you've been alone. Giving my heart a try, I know someday we'll find. Give me hope and stay true. Show my soul to you.
It's a collaborative project. It's called Synthetic Hearts. Dubazi and Msaki. Came out of a label called No Format. Europe-based. It's Radio 2000, our music, your memories. And of course, he just mesmerized us on the piano a couple of minutes ago. Say on the guitar, not the piano. I am seeing pianos now. And, you know, the acoustic guitar came through. But you were saying to us off the air that this album was challenging. Not as in saying it was hard, but it sort of put you in unfamiliar territory.
Absolutely.
Sonically, that is. Yeah. Take us through the motions of that.
So, you know, first of all, the album was written, I mean, at the time of the year. It was, during the break of... when the summer was just over and we were really getting into the beginning of winter, you know. Mm. So the leaves were actually turning from green to gold.
Right.
And we were out at Nyarox, and it was super cold. We had that opportunity to get into the space and to residency to write the album, you know. So we were staying there, and it was really cold. And the whole concept was put together. It was a great concept by the record label. Thanks to Laurent Bizot for putting it together. And I'm a singer, a collaborative artist, and, you know, an instrumentalist as well. Msaki as well, a singer. But when Laurent came up with this idea, he was like, hey, how about we do a vocal project between you and Msaki and a celloist? In my mind, I was like, no, man, how is this going to work?
Yeah.
Okay, who's going to play drums? Who's going to play guitars? No, 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 no. There's not going to be a super drum.
Just
voices. And me, I was like, no, I've never done anything like this.
Yes.
How's it going to work? Come to understand that Clément is an amazing celloist. He does this thing that he uses gadgets, he loops, he picks, he bows, he plays cello differently, you know. And he's like super open-minded, doesn't only read, but
full music.
He's really, really, most of the songs, I mean, if you listen to the instrumental part of it, it's just cello, and it's Clément playing, you know. And we go into a space, he played the songs, we did memos, we listened to the strongest ones, Psyche and I started writing, you know.
Yes.
The nice thing is Clément did this thing where he wrote the songs, he was miming. You know, like the oohs and the ahs, and we could pick that up, you know, and then we wrote lyrics. But also, here's the other thing. Didn't know what the album was going to sound like, what it's about. Me, I don't really write love songs. But this album, Synthetic Hearts, turned out to be a love album, you know.
And you fell in love with love songs.
Oh, no, definitely I fell in love, you know. And I don't sing like that. Like, if you listen to some of the projects I've done, i.e. Urban Village, you know, it's a CC into, and it's got like that, you know, warrior kind of singing. And, you know.
Yes.
And then this album, toned down.
Easy.
Stay as you are, till the days that you go linger. And Clément's like, you need to, with your lips, sort of pull back. You know. So I had to learn how to sing differently, how to get into a space. And it takes the mind, the heart, and a lot of preparation, and a lot of, it's a bit strenuous, you know.
But fulfilling.
Scary also, but fulfilling.
At the end of it all.
I'm loving how this project came out, really.
Got some voice notes that have come through. Let's take a listen. Cool. Ready 2000, our music, your memories. Toba Timoloy is our guest. Hi. Where is she? She's gone. All right, so we don't have.
We're going to take them after news, I think.
Okay, we're going to take them after the headlines. It's Radio 2000. It's
Music.
No, she was here, and then she just disappeared.
Yeah, no, it was a quick one.
It was a very quick one, wasn't it? All right, let's take those headlines. Radio 2000.
SABC News. Independent and impartial.
Thanks, Paul. Good evening. I'm Evelyn Dawani. The headlines. The leaders of the seven parties at the multi-party convention for South Africa have formally signed the Charter Cooperation Agreement at Kempton Park, east of Johannesburg. And public schools with 135 learners or less will be closed down if the Basic Education Laws Amendment Bill becomes law. And finally, 51-year-old Andries Boysen has been released on 2,000 rand bail after appearing in the Midrand Magistrate Court north of Johannesburg in connection with the alleged assault incident at Crothon Christian Academy at Midrand north of Johannesburg. More news at 6.
Get it first on your mobile, on the web, and on your dial. This is Radio 2000 Sport.
Good afternoon. In your final sport update, Sekhukhune United coach Brandon Truter has called for the suspension of match officials after his side lost 2-1 to Morocco Swallows, who awarded a dubious goal in the DStv Premiership clash last night. Although the rules were clear on goalkeepers not being challenged when they're in control of the ball, referee Siyabonga Nkomo ignored a foul on Sekhukhune keeper Badra Sangare, but Swallows striker Gabadinho Mhango. Truter, as expected, was livid.
It's poor. We watched a game on Monday night, European game, between Manchester United and Wolves United, where the officials got it wrong. VAR, the whole panel was suspended after that incident. And here in South Africa, we get away with decisions like that. It was the end clear for everybody to see a push on the goalkeeper. Even there, Benz confirms it.
We really do need VAR in this country. But newly appointed Marumo Gallant CEO Sinkim Nisi has vowed to guide the club back to the DCB Premiership next season. The vocal and colourful former Royal AM chief executive has himself made a return to football following his appointment by the relegated side. They've also roped in one of our favourite coaches, Bizo Dlala, who is the former coach of Richards Bay, as their new mentor. And Nisi says his mandate is clear.
It is often said that one man's poison is another man's meat. I'm here today as a chosen one, with the sole responsibility of delivering the team back in the Premier Division. That's the mandate that I got from.
That's clear.
Asazani and Omnis.
No, Kanjan. Nisi is one thing. Former South African 400 meter champion Zagiti Nene has expressed concern over the country's 4x400 meter relay team's inability to qualify for the World Athletics Championships in Budapest this month. The championships start on the 19th to the 27th of August, with Team South Africa sending a strong contingent made up of medal hopefuls, with World 400 meter record holder Wade van Niekerk, under 20 World 400 meter record holder Lyth Pele and Nene among those set to compete in the individual events. The latter believes there was an even stronger prospect of securing a medal in the relay.
I'm not going to lie, that's actually really, really disappointing, you know, given the time that the guys have ran this year. I think this is probably like the strongest 400 meter group, you know, that we've ever had.
And finally, in swimming, World Aquatics will debut a new open category for transgender athletes at this year's Swimming World Cup event in Berlin. Last year, the world governing body voted to stop transgender athletes from competing in the women's elite races. The open category will feature 50 meters and 100 meter races across all strokes. Last year, World Aquatics said the open category would be for swimmers whose gender identity is different than their birth sex. Describing the creation of the open category in Berlin as a pioneer pilot project, World Aquatics said more events could be added. Let's leave it on that rather controversial note. For Radio 2000 Sport, I am Luna Bongotla.
Drive Connection on Radio 2000, a human connection by design.
Yeah, I know, it resonates. Tubatsi, as well as Msaki on this one. It's Radio 2000, our music, your memories. Stay as you are. We got some voice notes that have been coming through. Let's take a listen to what you have to say. Hi.
Hi, Radio 2000. I just wanted to say, Jingum Dana Tonga, Dubat, you have just awoken the spirit, and I just wanted to say, with the song that I just played now, we appreciate you so much. I appreciate you so much personally, because you just invoked something, but most of all, you have just answered a few questions that I've been having a few days ago.
Wow.
So, Siabong, I'm Dana Tonga. May you be blessed with your gift and you keep sharing. And please share where you will be playing and where are you around the country so that we can support. But apart from that, I want to say, thank you.
Wow, so
wow. Wow, that's beautiful.
Beautiful, isn't it? Cool, yeah? It's a big responsibility, isn't it?
Yeah. Bona, if you're given a responsibility, you must just embrace it and don't be afraid.
Bona, but it's huge.
Right. As huge as it is.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's small, you know, but I appreciate it, you know. Yeah. I mean, I've realized it, you know, when you know, yeah, it comes with great responsibility. It
does indeed.
Yeah. Yeah, it's that power, eh? Yeah, mara siyabonga kakhulu. Yeah, but again, we all have an equal responsibility to look after one another and this universe as well. So let's all play our part. You know, I'm also trying to tell my story as much as I can. Mm. Thanks for the opportunity.
Yes.
You know, yeah.
Indeed.
Yeah.
Let's listen to what you have to say.
Hey, kwadla kwadla, mniswemvula.
That's my
right. Umpemba lo.
Oh, Umpemba.
We're sitting with the future there.
Oh, yeah?
The future is there.
Yes.
Yeah, the legend. Big up, my brother. Keep it up. Keep up the good work. We enjoy every moment with you. You're a star.
Oh, man.
Each other.
Oh, thank you so much.
Isn't that beautiful?
Hey, that's beautiful. Uncle John, thank
Uncle
you so
John.
Much. Uncle John. I know that voice. Definitely do. But yeah. Once again, thank you so much.
Uncle John. Appreciate what's going on, Uncle John?
Tubat, you in your own dimension of being unique and excellent. And people of your caliber, like all-rounders, are not spoiled in terms of inspiration. Who do you look up to? How many people do you look at yourself and say that? And that,
yeah,
or where everything started, yeah,
absolutely. Me, I grew up, when you see an elderly person in the street, he or she, you know,
yeah,
I look after to the elderly people, the older people that you know had come before me, whether you know it doesn't have to be mkulu koko rumalume, you know, but I can honestly say I was raised by my grandpa and my grandma, you know, so nkhuliseng aleso sizwathaleso sasekhaya nkhulile lokushini, you know. And I have a few people that I can say I look up to musically, you know, spiritually, and I could really talk about it and mention all of people.
Let's say know? Musically, because guys who are unique as you are not spoiled for inspiration. You know, common artists can pick there and pick there and pick there. What do you pick?
From the top of my head, may his soul rest in peace. Tate Philip Tabane. Tate Philip Tabane is a genius. Dr. Philip Tabane, you know. He created a genre, you know, and malombo. Mm-hmm. And it's blues, you know, taken from a European space. But he made it malombo in South African and African. Yeah. He left it for us. I'm one of those artists who are, you know, working on a project on the side to really dedicate it to malombo art, you know, because I feel good to that has not been also like, you know, really exercised that much and never really get to be, you know, experienced that much. But yes, Tate Philip Tabane, siyabonga kakhulu. Siyabonga kakhulu. Madala kunene, singababiza, singaqhubeka, singaqhubeka given the time, you know.
The list is long.
Uba for set right there.
Yes, not too long ago, actually.
Yeah.
Wabanjwa umoya.
But I want to know about the greater dream. You know, when we're listening to this music, we're hearing something that is can't be limited to just here. It needs to go to other planets.
Absolutely.
But what is the dream for you? And I know there have been a few challenges that you spoke about off air. But when the challenges are done, where are we going with this?
You know, music is a beautiful collaboration between sounds and vibrations. And for me, I've been with this kind of project and working closely with the record label No Format. I've had an opportunity to work with kids, you know, especially kids from Europe and kids from other parts, and collaborate with other people who don't even necessarily know our language. I did a project with, you know, the French schools where I'd shared Amahubo, you know, and izingoma ebesizicula amasikhula thina in South Africa as kids, you know, because they have a South African and African week, music week festival happening.
Yes.
So I had an opportunity to teach the kids how to sing the songs, what the songs mean, like Sabona abazali bephethe imithwalo ncincibo ncincibo sizodla sisuthe,
that kind of thing,
you know, what does it mean, what are we singing about, you know. So the kids had to learn that. So for me, the dream is bigger than just being able to just, you know, share the art and the music emzansi. It is for me also to have the opportunity to open up to other spaces and go learn other people's cultures, you know, because we learn from the streets, some of us, and some of us go to university and learn those things and then you know, like, sort of apply them. So for me, it is to be able to share this language with other parts of the world, really, you know. And it's a conversation through music. I think we can do that through art, paint, dance, photography, and fortunately I'm also in the, you know, cracks of, you know, the space of the music, and therefore we can have this conversation.
Take heed, nasi sivungvu, yes ba.
Asibi.
Take heed, Dumats.
Imvula yanetha. I was in Cape Town with a friend of mine, Santa Marie, last month, and we were doing this tour. It was a winter tour.
Yes.
It's a thing of doing new things. Mm. And then there was snow in Joburg, and I'm in Cape Town, and like people are having fun and out there, you know. And I got inspired where I was working, and
yes.
So basically, it's a song. It's not out. It's not. It's new. It was actually something I'd done then. And I like to share it. It's just the art of being, you know, just being able to create something and play on the spot.
You call it Izi Vung Vung?
No.
What's this one? Hey. Okay, let's hear it. Tuba, it's full of surprises.
Snow.
Snow. Okay,
go. In Joburg.
In Joe's.
It was a long and dark July. From the windows they were watching, there was snow, white snow. Clearly I remember, from the windows they were watching, there was snow, white snow. Watching, there was snow, white snow. Clearly I remember, from the windows they were watching, when that snow, oh, white snow. White snow.
I'm gonna call the song Istwa. Call it Istwa.
I'm here for the versatility.
Man.
I mean,
at some point, you know, you could have been listening to Sting and the Police. And then you could have, you know what I mean? It's just that your dynamic and how you stretch yourself musically is just something to behold. And take it, Dubai.
Absolutely.
Take it, man.
You know why?
Take it.
You know why?
Yes.
Music, art, let me just be honest.
Yes.
It's got no color, no creed, no whatsoever.
Yes, indeed.
And we have to change the norm. The narrative needs to change.
Yes.
I don't just play music for a specific race of people. I do not speak only in a specific language, you know. I'm pro-black, yes, Kimosuotu, and you know, I'm really strong about those things, but we need to be able to change the narrative. We've
yes.
got kids that are growing up. We need to change this world, you know. We need to change the way we do things. So I want to spread my wings and just like try to, you know, have a conversation that's like really universal. I mean, honestly, and really universal, you know.
Yes.
So Naminyazama, and like I said, this song is also it's inspired. Every song is inspired by another song. Mm. This one is inspired by Coldplay, you know.
Right.
I used to listen to a lot of Coldplay, and it's got that touch. And I guess I was in Cape Town on a specific tour in a certain mood, and I guess it came at that time, you know.
Yeah.
And ingoma's fine, and you figure like it's Coldplay, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then now the language. The other day I was dreaming, you know, and I woke up, and when I woke up in the morning, I was told that, hey man, that is all when you were speaking, you know, you're doing teen. But the language we call it's like a nomadic or something, but you could hear it's something.
Right.
Therefore, you realize how connected we are.
Hey, what we feel about the vagash.
Abubani, batin, babuya. I was sneaking against was going to stand the same.
It's really 2000 hour music, your memories with Tubatsi Moloi. And of course, just looking into that collaborative album, Synthetic Hearts, that he did with Umsaki. Performances, you've been quite busy. Length and breadth of the country. What's upcoming?
You know, I realized that things have changed, you know, post-COVID, you know?
Yes.
As creatives, we really took a knock, you know, and we had time to go back to the drawing board. So I'm also trying to, you know, change the model, you know, try and see what else. I mean, this is a different time. Things, the industry has changed so much, we have to do things differently. So I've been collaborating a lot because I've realized my strongest point is I am a collaborative artist.
Yes.
And that's how I learn. So I've been doing a lot of collaborations. There's a good friend of mine I met a couple of months ago, Senna Marie.
Okay.
She's a musician, a guitarist, songwriter.
Where's she from?
She's from Joburg. She's from Joburg, and she's written a beautiful album called, it's not an album, it's an EP called Fence Sitter. If you have time, please listen to it.
I will.
And we've been collaborating on that, and we've been doing tours, and we did the second tour. We were in Cape Town. We did all these venues, and people received us so well, you know, and most of the venues were so filled up. And now the project goes on because now I'm also in a space where I want to release my own EP. And but obviously you have to raise funds for all of those things.
Correct.
So speaking of that, on the 26th, it was meant to be on the 25th of August, but I had a young incident, you know, physically. So I had to see the doctors. And so the whole thing was moved to the 26th of August. I'll be at Breeze Blocks in Brixton.
That's just down the hill.
Yeah, beautiful.
Way up the hill. It's just down the hill on the other side, right? Yes.
So I'll be at Breeze Blocks, and I'm doing this beautiful event. It's all about collaboration. I'm collaborating with the chef at Breeze Block called Culinary Pansula.
Okay.
So I'm collaborating my art with the music, you know, and with the audience. So it's a 3-course meal. And
so he's going to cook something around the atmosphere.
Absolutely. She's going to cook something around the atmosphere. I'm going to perform like performative art, you know, collaborating with that, the food. And then I've prepared like a screening of a film that we'd shot a couple of months ago, also at Nyarox, curated it as well.
Aren't you the space cadet? Like,
we're trying to do things out of the norm, you know?
Yes.
So there'll be that screening, and we only have 4 hours to do this, 5 hours, you know, to really do this. How are we going to do it? I don't know. It's something new, never been done before, but I think it's a nice model. So also I have other musicians that I'll be playing with, Lungile Kuneno on drums, Sakile Mpendulo on bass, Buitumelo, and also Senna Marie. So there'll be the music, sort of like collaborating. It's not going to be a normal show where you go to a show and song number one, hey, thank you so much. This song is this. Right. Next song, yeah, thank you so much.
It's going to be interactive.
It's going to be interactive because I want to interact and collaborate with the space, the people, the food, the musicians, and we all hold space together. Something else could come out of that. I want to see how this model is going to work.
So this is August, what, the 25th?
26th August. Yes. It's going to be on a Saturday in Brixton. The Breeze Block. Please come through. We're selling tickets at Quickit, and we're very strict about it because it's a different kind of model. Tickets are only going to be sold on Quickit because the food also that's going to be prepared is prepared for, you know, the heads and
the amount of people who are coming.
Absolutely
through.
And we're only taking 60 people, and the tickets are selling quite fast.
Beautiful.
Yeah, but
beautiful.
We'd appreciate it. Please come through and just share with us this experience.
Send us home with one
more.
I'm niggling, right? I'm like this.
You got what you want.
I'm like, you know, this little, what do you call these little dogs biting at the ankles, right? What do we call this one, Tubatsi?
Keep your head up.
Keep your head up. Tubatsi Malone. Live and unplugged, ladies and gentlemen. It's the Drive Connection.
I spend my time watching spaces that had grown between us, and I got my mind on second best. All the scars that come with the greenness, and I get my eyes to the bottom. Still the seabed wouldn't let me in, and I tried my best
to embrace the darkness in which I swim. Walking down this mountain with the strength of a turning tide, the wind so soft on my skin, or the sun so hot on my side. I search for between the sheets, I realize all I was searching for was me. All I was searching for was me. Keep your head up, keep your heart strong. My. Keep your mind set, keep your head long. Oh my darling, keep your head up, keep your heart strong. My keep your mind set in your ways. Keep your heart strong. Remember you the same. Eyes like wildflower. I'll always remember you the same. Eyes like wildflower.
Ladies and gentlemen, Radio 2000, our music, your memories. We'll check you out on the 26th of August at Breeze Block.
Thank you so much.
And that's our show.
Yeah. I'm so excited about this one. I'm really
it's gonna
excited.
Be great. It sounds like it's going to be great. Yeah.
This is a banana con.
There you go. And that's our show, folks. Lonab.
Hey.
Simgil.
No, we're gone. We done did it.
Yeah, Val.
Agenda.
Dival.
Yeah.
Take us away.
1, 2, 3, 4. Take me away, them first prophet here, one lead I astray. Who I beg you, Father, shine on my way. Oh, I say thy name shall be praised, thy name shall be praised. Say thy name shall be praised, thy name shall be praised again. Take me away, them first prophet here, one lead I astray. Who I beg you, Father, shine on my way. I say thy name shall be praised, thy name shall be praised. Say thy name shall be praised, thy name shall be praised. Say thy name shall be praised, thy name shall be praised. It happened too many times.